A life sentence.
He will be locked up, probably in a prison for young people.
Got to go to prison for at least 20 years.
Across the UK, children are locked up almost every day for committing serious crimes. You hear about it in the papers, on the telly, even in the playground. But what's it like for the kids who end up behind bars?
I've been locked up for about 3 Christmases now, and I haven't been with my family either, and birthdays as well, 4 birthdays.
When there's no point of getting into trouble because you end up just getting locked up all your life, don't you? And it ain't worth it.
It's just not good, is it, being locked up, your freedom's taken away. I just want to be out getting on with my life.
At the moment, there are well over 1,000 children aged 16 and under in custody in the UK. Some as young as 10 are punished for their crimes by being sent to places like this. A secure unit in the southwest of England, it houses some of the country's most badly behaved children. We've been given some very rare access. We've disguised all the children in this film and changed their names so they can't be identified when they're released.
23 children, both boys and girls, live here away from their families. They have to follow very strict rules and each night are locked in their rooms.
Jake is serving 3 years and 9 months for robbery and theft. He's been in and out of secure units since he was 11 years old. He's now 14.
I stopped going to school when I was about 10 or 11. And then I started mixing with the wrong people and stuff like that. So we started breaking the law, robbing people and just stupid things like that. And then we went to court and just ended up here, innit? It's horrible. You got asked to go to the toilet, everything like that. Change the channel on the TV, it's horrible.
Do you hate being told what to do every minute of every day? Or in some ways, do you quite enjoy having a structure?
I'm better with a structure, but I got a bit of a short temper, so if someone tells me, sometimes I can take it. And sometimes if I'm in a bit of a bad mood, I've woke up on the wrong side of the bed, I get a bit angry. And if you kicks off, you get restrained, don't you? Which ain't very nice.
In this country, we lock up 4 times as many children as in France, 10 times as many as in Spain, and 100 times more than in Finland. And we have one of the youngest ages of criminal responsibility in Europe. From the age of 10, you are held responsible for any crime you commit, and if it's bad enough, you could end up behind bars. Being locked up is a last resort and only happens when children have committed a very serious crime like murder or robbery, or have broken the law over and over again. Children who've been found guilty by a court of law of a crime serious enough for them to be locked up can be sent to 3 different places.
Young offender institutions for older children, they're similar to adult prisons. Secure training centres where they concentrate on education. And places like this, a local authority secure children's home, or secure units as they're usually called. They are where the youngest and most vulnerable children end up. Every child arriving at the secure unit is searched. It's to check they're not carrying anything that could harm them, including drugs or weapons. They're then checked out by a nurse and are assigned a key worker who will look after them throughout their stay.
Coverage a day. Now, is there anything that you would like to bring up?
Other kids, they annoy me.
What do you think we might be able to do about that?
Sol's always had a thing about cars, but at 14, he's too young for a driving licence. He's been locked up before for stealing and driving cars, but it didn't put him off. So when he was caught joyriding again, he was sentenced to 12 months.
It got to a point where I was just doing it for secret and just driving around like they were my own cars. I felt really gutted when I first ever got locked up. I thought, oh, I'd never get locked up in stir. I don't care really about being locked in because once you're here, the first couple of days you'll think, oh, I'm just taking a mick. But then I just think you get used to it really because there ain't nothing you can do.
Many of the children here come from very difficult backgrounds. Violence at home, neglect, poor mental health are just some of the problems faced. For some, this will be the safest place they've ever been.
Ray's been locked up 11 times now. At the moment, he's serving 2 years for robbery. He's 14.
I punch people for their money and put a knife to them for their money and took the stuff off them. That's it, really. That's the worst thing I've ever done.
What's it like coming here? Is it sometimes a bit of a rest from the outside world?
Yeah, a rest from stealing and getting arrested. Because when I was at home, I never used to really go home. Just stay out with my mates all night. And here, I'm just looked after proper. You eat properly here as well, and outside I didn't used to eat.
So what do you miss the most?
My mates and my family. My mum feels like she feels normal now. It's like part of her life that I keep getting locked up. And my friends are locked up, most of them anyway, so. Okay.
Go to number 7. Serious, go to number 7. Do it, do it,
Education is a big part of life in a secure unit. Almost half the children who end up in custody have trouble reading, and over half the children will have been excluded from school. Routine is important, so every day here is pretty much the same. You get fed, go to lessons, tidy your room, and then there are special classes such as understanding the effect their crimes have had on their victims.
As well as a full day of activities, the children are allowed a break for some fun. But you're never alone. There's security everywhere. You can't go anywhere without someone watching your every move.
The children who come here are helped to understand what went wrong with their lives and why they shouldn't break the law again. They're given skills to cope with the outside world when they're released.
We want to give them the power to be able to live their lives to the best of their ability when they leave. Things like making good decisions, knowing how to behave with adults and other young people outside, and to be able to take up opportunities which in the past they've not been able to do because they haven't had the life skills.
Incentive schemes are one of the ways the secure unit helps children learn how to behave properly. Good behaviour is rewarded with points, which can eventually gain you privileges like a TV or a later bedtime. But life in a secure unit isn't easy. Arguments between children, bullying and loneliness can be a real problem.
Good things is the incentives and stuff. And the bad things is when you can think that you're friends with people and people start being two-faced.
Being locked up is hard because you have to prove yourself to loads of people, and I was small when I first come here, so I had to fight them.
Reoffending is a big problem. Around 6 out of 10 children who end up in custody will go on to commit another crime within a year of being released.
You get immune to it anyway. Like, you get locked up the first time, yeah, you have your cry, you get annoyed and stuff. You come back the second time and you meet your friends and stuff and you get out, and it's just like a circle, innit? You're either out of the circle or in the circle, innit?
So having been in it like so many times, was the first time not bad enough?
I didn't really want to stay out then. I just wanted to go out and have a laugh again. It weren't a long enough sentence to learn anything, but I don't think. So, you know, I just wanted to mess about with all the boys again.
Some people believe locking up children is not the answer to cutting back on youth crime. Charities and politicians are now campaigning to stop it happening. They reckon dealing with young offenders in the community is a better idea.
Do you think this works as a punishment for crime?
No.
Why not?
Because people are still coming back and doing crime.
What do you think would work?
To get a really long sentence and just not want to ever come back again. And then I'll just stop.
So I'm getting picked up tomorrow at 10, so we're saying good riddance to these pigs.
It's Sol's last day at the secure unit. He's been let out early for good behaviour, but he'll have to wear an electronic tag so people know where he is. He'll also have to report to the youth offending team at least twice a week. He's excited about going home, but also a bit worried as he's got a bad reputation.
I'm quite embarrassed at the point where, like as I was saying, people look at me funny and stuff and they're like, after I walk past, I can see they check all their cars and stuff, like see whether I've done anything and that. And whenever something happens around my area, police come and see me straight away.
How determined are you not to put yourself in a position where you can come back to this?
I don't think I'd ever put myself in that position again because I just don't think it's worth it. I've ruined things for like my mum, like they'll never trust me like they used to. I think it's changed my life because I think now I've wasted so much time. I've wasted like an eighth of my life in like secure units.
Jake's still got a long time to go before he's let out. He wants to be a chef and is working towards it. Ray's learnt to read properly and is looking forward to leaving the secure unit next month. A week after being let out, Sol got into trouble again. He's now back behind bars.